Does thermal paste wear out, and does it need a break-in period? Howdy, howdy, guys. Ponchato here, and welcome to the third episode of Quick Questions. Today, we'll be revisiting the first two videos in which I replaced my old thermal paste with a different brand because I didn't know Arctic Silver was still actually making Arctic Silver 5 thermal paste, now almost a decade later. First, we'll test if old thermal paste wears out. The test system is my old i5-750 build from around 2010 with a Cooler Master Hyper 212 Plus cooling the CPU and Arctic Silver 5 thermal paste. I cleaned up the old paste with isopropyl alcohol and cotton swabs to ensure that we're working with a clean slate. Normally, it's not that big of a deal to just clean up the old paste with a paper towel, but since we're specifically testing the thermal paste, the temperature difference might only be a few degrees, so we need to make sure it's as accurate as possible. After getting it all cleaned up, I added a line of Arctic Silver 5 thermal paste to the heat spreader and reinstalled the cooler. Before replacing the roughly 8-year-old Tim, I recorded the temperatures of the i5-750 at idle and while stress testing with Prime 95. All of these results were taken in a room at 24 degrees Celsius. At idle, the 750 sat at around 32 degrees Celsius, and under load, it peaked at 63. After replacing the thermal paste with identical Arctic Silver 5, the new idle temperature was 30 degrees Celsius, and the new temperature under load was 60. That's 2 degrees cooler at idle and 3 degrees cooler under load. I do have some stipulations regarding these results, but I'll address those at the end of the video. The next test, or retest in this case, is whether or not thermal paste has a break-in period. In other words, do you have to let your computer run for 24 or 48 hours before thermal paste reaches its maximum efficiency, or is it already the best it's going to be as soon as the CPU cooler is installed? I'm including the results from the first QQ video addressing this, which uses Deepcool Z5 thermal paste, just to have another set of data points with a different TIM. Here's the graph of CPU temperature measurements taken right after replacing the thermal paste, then after 3 hours, 6, 9, 12, 24, and finally 5 days after replacement. Note that the x-axis is not to scale. Initial idle temperatures were 29 and 30 degrees Celsius, and stress test temperatures were 60 and 61. 5 days later, idle temps were 29 and 31 degrees, while stress temperatures for both thermal paste were 60 degrees Celsius. Based on these results, in a similar conclusion to the second quick questions video, it doesn't look like thermal paste really has a break-in period. Though, like in the first part of this video, I have some stipulations. Back to the first question, does thermal paste wear out? There are a few problems with testing this. First, and most important, the manner in which you apply thermal paste has an arguably larger effect on temperatures than the choice of thermal paste itself. Even with the best thermal paste available, if you apply it incorrectly, it will perform worse than even pre-applied TIM that comes on Intel and AMD stock coolers. On top of that, it's very difficult to apply thermal paste identically each time you test it. This means to get really accurate results, you should be testing 5 or 10 samples rather than just one to balance out any variation in how the paste is applied or how much is applied. That leads us to the second problem, which is time. In order to test thermal paste wearing out, you need to let it sit for 5 or 8 or 10 years. I could set up 15 PCs and leave them in a closet to accurately test whether thermal paste wears out, but we won't have those results until 2027. For now, based on the data we do have, I'd say there's a good chance that thermal paste actually does wear out, and if you're focused on getting the highest possible overclock or lowest possible temperatures, replacing it every few years is worth the couple minutes that it takes. Now, regarding the second question, does thermal paste need to be broken in? The problem with a general question like this is that it could very well depend on the individual thermal paste. The two that I tested here, Arctic Silver 5 and Deepcool Z5, don't appear to have a break-in period. However, that story could change if you're using paste from Cooler Master or Noctua or Thermaltake, or even if you're using a different paste from Arctic Silver or Deepcool. My gut tells me that in the vast majority of cases, the results here will hold true. Thermal paste doesn't need to be broken in. But it's not entirely accurate to say that in every case, thermal paste doesn't need a break-in period, and there's really no way of saying that for certain without testing literally every thermal interface solution. Having mentioned that, I will say that for the vast majority of people, you probably don't need to worry about a break-in period. To get notified of new videos as soon as they're up, hit subscribe, then click the bell icon to enable notifications. Also, join the Discord if you want to be a cool kid. That's linked in the description. So guys, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe. And if you have any questions on thermal paste or the results in this video, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. I hope I helped, and I'll see you in the next video.